Reading a text file in Java is not too dissimilar from reading from the keyboard. In both cases, we'll use a scanner object to parse the text. The big difference is how we select the file to read. In the class countWordsInFile, we have a static method selectTextFile that will allow the user to pick a file using a dialog box. The jFileChooser class allows us to display a file open dialog, just like you'd see in any other application. First, we create an object of the jFileChooser class. Next, we want to look for files ending in .txt or .java, so we create a file name extension filter object and set that to be the filter for the object chooser. We display the dialog by calling chooser's showOpenDialog method. We pass null as a parameter because we don't have a GUI window. Running the program, we see that this displays a normal file open dialog, showing only Java and text files, and allows us to select either open or cancel. Looking back at the code, we see that showOpenDialog returns a value, indicating whether we selected open or cancel. If the return value is equal to the constant approve option, then we have selected a file and attempt to create and return a scanner with the selected file. If not, the user selected cancel and we simply return null. It's possible that the user might type in an invalid file name. In that case, a file not found exception will be thrown when we try to create the scanner. We catch that exception and display an error dialog using a static method in the JOptionPane class. Note that for a static method, we use nameOfClass.nameOfMethod and don't first have to create a JOptionPane object. The do while true loop guarantees we will keep displaying the file open dialog until either the user selects a valid file or picks cancel. Now let's look at the main method for this class. Before calling the selectTextFile method, we set the look and feel for the application to the system look and feel. This way, the file open dialog looks like other applications on your system, rather than the Java cross-platform dialog. We use the static method setLookAndFeel in the UIManager class to accomplish this, passing it the result of the static method getSystemLookAndFeel class name. Since setLookAndFeel might throw an exception, although not with the parameter we pass, we are required to enclose it in a try-catch block. We then call selectTextFile. If it doesn't return null, we'll process the file. When processing a text file, it is generally useful to process one line at a time. The while loop reads a line from the file and passes it to the countWordsOnLine method, repeating until there are no more lines. We add all of the results of the countWordsOnLine calls together and display that as the total number of words in the file. The countWordsOnLine method creates a scanner for the string containing the line that was passed to it. It also has a while loop, calling next repeatedly to count the number of words on the line. Each iteration of the loop corresponds to a single word, so the variable count is incremented. At the end, the value of count, the number of words on the line, is returned. Finally, we'll show the results of running the program and selecting a valid file. As you can see, it displays the number of words in the file.